Well, there's no time like the present to just jump right in and produce this video here. We're just going to use this simple background. I have been touting the day July 5th, 2012, which is today, in several recent videos saying how important it is. And wouldn't you know it, on the morning of July 5th, as I was sleeping lightly, sort of waking up and then going back to sleep, I had what can only be termed as a multidimensional experience. And I guess if you've ever had one, you know what I'm talking about. And if you haven't, there's no way I can describe it accurately, because any description would be flat. And multi-dimensional experience doesn't translate into a flat experience. And this experience has shed enormous light in all directions. And it made it very clear that what we have been trying to do is we've been trying to fake a multi-dimensional experiencing. We've been trying to fake it. This world is an attempt to fake it. And all of us have been homesick for multidimensionality, and we've been trying to, you know, simulate it. When we stop entirely wanting to fake it, then we try to simulate it. We want to get some sense of it, some feel of it. But here's an analogy. Let's say we have a glass of water, cool, refreshing water, and then someone takes a picture of it, many pictures of it, and tries to make really beautiful pictures of it, and prints them on a flat page, and everybody is spending all their time looking at these pictures of the water and oohing and aahing and discussing which one of these pictures is better, you know, which one makes us feel better, which one satisfies us more. And and someone comes along and says, why don't you just drink the water? Here's this glass of water, just drink it, drink it. And people say, what? No, these pictures are so much better. Well, these pictures are like the third dimension, or any dimension, any single dimension, so to speak. It's flat. It is not experiencing multidimensionally. And I'll tell you this, after experiencing that multidimensional experience, the question someone asked me, would you want to go back to faking it, or a single dimensional flat experience? Or after that, then the answer would be no way, no way. There's no way that anybody who experiences multidimensionality would want to continue on in a flat single dimensionality. Simply no way. And the idea that somehow we would be satisfied with all this fakery, this trickery, this simulation, trying to simulate multidimensionality is ridiculous. The fact that it is fakery, simulation, is obvious. And the fact that it's just like a picture of a glass of water, it's obvious that that's not the water. It's obvious that's not going to quench our thirst. We have a thirst for multidimensionality, experiencing that way. And no fake or simulation of that is going to quench our thirst at all. Okay. Now, this background here is something that I did. And you know, if you look at it, it's pretty it's a simulation, as it were, of multidimensionality. We're using pictures of the great guru on the right, Ananda Maima. We have on the pictures on the left, we have pictures of Jesus Christ. On the top, we have pictures of the Palm Springs area, beautiful golf courses there, and then on the bottom we have the artwork of Nicholas Roerich, and then we have them all moving in like a film strip type of style, and we have them all kind of interwoven on top of a beautiful background. And you can see here that this is an attempt to simulate multidimensionality, which was what creative people on this planet are trying to do. Okay, I've done it in past lives. I've done it this life. I was desperately trying to find some way to show people here what is multidimensionality like? Having come out of multidimensionality into this world and experiencing the flatness here and the horrible fakery here, I'm trying to give people a feel of it, you know. Can you simulate it? And I knocked myself out trying to do this throughout my life, trying to find some way to simulate multidimensionality. But having experienced it so profoundly this morning of July 5th, 2012, you know, it's obviously such efforts are futile. Really, they're futile. And that's what I have seen, is that what really works is the spiritual path that clarifies and removes obstructions and objections and reluctances from us to experience multidimensionality. And that then leads to the direct experiencing of it, which is the only thing that will quench our thirst. And immersing oneself in artwork, you know, which we do. I mean, I could throw some extremely good music, some very interwoven, beautiful music behind this background here, and that would, you know, add to the simulation of it. And there's lots of different ways that people try to simulate multidimensionality. Beautiful graphics and beautiful music. They might have some incense. They might have a party going on. They might have lots of different kinds of food. Yeah, and you have to understand, I see it all now. It's like, wow, what we're trying to do is we're trying to simulate multidimensionality here in 3D. So completely obvious. So completely futile. Again, anyone who's tasted a glass of water, they're never going to settle for a pitcher of water. Completely obvious that this is true. So, you know, once you've had that taste, oh boy, you just, the simulations just don't cut it. Multidimensionality is like so rich. It's really, really infinitely rich. The experiencing is infinitely rich. The seamless flowing of it. There's just no end to the depth that one can access instantly, and just pull anything together. Any style, any expression can be seamlessly flows into any other expression. You can just choose anything, and it's just the depth is just, you know, it never ends. And it feels like, wow, this is life. This is life. And this attempt to fake it, to fake multidimensionality, which is what we're trying to do, we're trying to fake it. That's not life. That's poverty. But we're in a state of supreme impoverishment. No matter how clever our fakery is, you get a symphony orchestra, you know, in the best concert hall, and the audience there, and you're playing the best compositions, and just everyone is there and into it, and you know, it's still just complete fakery, totally flat. And we come away and we think, well, I think I had an experience there. I'm not sure. It's kind of, you know, really kind of interesting. We can talk about it, etc. Oh, when you experience multidimensionality, there's no talking. You're not talking about it. You're not thinking about it. it's this rich expression of creative expression that you're just playing it. I mean, you are it. You're experiencing, weaving an endless tapestry, and you're pulling in threads from everywhere. And every thread seamlessly flows with every other thread you've pulled in. And it's obvious that the digital age here is just a sophisticated attempt to fake multidimensionality. Totally obvious. Crystal clear. Because of course, with all the sampling and all the different ways we can store data, etc., you can put, you know, like on a keyboard, like a synthesizer. I used to play, synthesizers and had all the sampling, and it could, you could bring up, every different instrument and chorus and all these vast banks of sounds, and then you hit the keyboard and you can blend them together, etc. And so there's all these attempts by the digital technology to fake multidimensionality. But the actual experiencing of multidimensionality is astonishingly rich. And it's right now, you're right in the middle of it. You're weaving, you're the weaver of the threads. And it all flows together perfectly. Different than fakery. No matter how superb the fakery is carried out, it's still flat. Okay? And yet the fakers, they take great pride in how well can I fake it? And they think that the only purpose of those who have experienced multidimensionality is to tell us, how good our fakery is, and what areas we can improve on it, etc., which is nuts. That's like saying a photographer asking, how can I take a better photograph of a glass of water so it seems more realistic? As if the teacher is here, the multidimensional experiencer is here to just advise photographers how to take a better photograph of a glass of water. That's nonsense, crazy. No, the teachers, the gurus, the multidimensionals are here to tell you, stop trying to fake it and actually experience it. Stop trying to take photos of water and drink the darn glass of water. That's what they're saying. It's so obvious. And yet we continue to try and figure out ways to make things seem multidimensional within a single dimension. Why? Because we want to be prime creator. And we don't want to function the way we were created to function. We were created to function what's called multidimensionally. This is just a term. It's really even beyond that, really. It's more of a situation where you are simply able to pull in threads of expression and creativity and weave endless, gorgeous tapestries that it all simply fits together. There's no disharmony. There's no disconnect. And the combinations are infinite. And it's effortless. And it's just this incredible richness and feeling of creativity that's just marvelous. Everything, trying to fake it always will come up short, but we're in our arrogance, we're trying to think, hey, maybe we can be prime creator, and we can dwell in a single flat linear experiencing, and pull in multidimensionality can be an effect of that. We can be very artistic and very creative here in 3D or 4D or 5D or 2D, whatever single dimensionality there is. It was truly an accurate prediction that I gave. I said there's something. I said we just have to make it to July 5th. That's all important. I don't. And I said the time before that's gonna be extremely difficult, very, very difficult. But suddenly we're going to turn a corner, and something really good is going to come. There's going to be very much a parting of the ways between those who want to continue to keep faking multidimensionality and those who want to actually experience it. And wouldn't you know, July 5th, boom. I've been having incredible dreams recently. Dreams have taken on a even greater vividness, color, detail, and they've somehow boosted up. The dreams have been boosted to a large extent over the last couple of weeks, I would say. Remarkable. And then this multidimensional dream of just pulling in so many threads and just beautiful. On July 5th. So we have made it. Congratulations to everyone. You've made it. You've made it to July 5th, where we did receive a big boost, where multidimensionality now is kicking in. And all we have to do is simply open to it. We simply have to say, okay, yeah. And just let go of faking it and not be worried about functioning the way we were created to function. A creativity unknown to those who are faking it. Those who are faking it are very clever. Very, very clever. But what is cleverness next to true creativity? Nothing. You know, it's nothing. It's like a piece of paper. What do you do with a photograph of a glass of water? What do you do with it? You put it on in a frame and put it on a wall? I guess so. And then worship it and bow to it? I mean, I guess that's what they're doing in 3D. That's what the those who reject multidimensionality are just worshiping idols. Still clinging to their desire to be prime creator, refusing the infinite riches of multidimensionality. We don't have to do that anymore. We can finally say, okay, this is how we're supposed to function. And let's just allow it. So the next 6 months for us is going to be a truly fantastic time. Truly fantastic time. When you have an experience in multidimensionality, you will know it. Because it's just got the wow factors off the charts. Yeah. It's not just an amazing situation. It is a... You'll feel a creativity that you haven't experienced in a long, long time. Since you tried to fake multidimensionality. You haven't had this experience. And then you'll feel it like, oh my gosh, you said, that is really, really, really creative. You'll feel that way, like this just off the charts creative and effortless, so easy and amazing. And you'll say, this just surpasses anything the world can offer as far as creative expression. You'll just know it. You'll know it. And then you say, welcome back home, welcome to multidimensionality. It feels normal, it feels natural, it feels like, this is what I'm supposed to be doing. I'm not supposed to be fooling around in this ridiculous flatland of non-multidimensionality, of faking it, simulating it, pretending. All this stuff that we've been doing is just rubbish. Really. And then you know you are waking up to your natural functioning. I don't know how this fits in with unconditional love. I'm not really sure at this moment. It doesn't really matter. It may be that... who knows? I will have to see. I will wait and see. I'm patient enough to let things develop. But I just need to report this, and maybe some of you have had multi-dimensional experiences. Strange dreams. I mean, dreams that just, you know, are just wow. You say, oh, something is really changing. Something is going on big time right now. July 5th. I had other dreams, too, that were just amazing. Holy cow. Some of them looking back at the world of flesh and that was horrifying. Oh my gosh, it was like necrotic. The world of the death. I mean, the body was just like cheesy, necrotic flesh. It was just horrifying. The sickness and disease I saw there. And I saw other things in space, and that was just... there is really, really... marvelous, incredible situation that has kicked into high gear starting July 5th. So we are in a great time, and we need to accept it. Accept it. We're not in a bad time anymore. Yes, those who are trying to continue to fake multidimensionality are going to go through some very severe situations. But those who are ready to embrace multidimensionality, oh boy, we're going to experience something that we just beyond our imagination, really. And one of the big steps that I took was to put everything in Creative Commons. All the creative work I've ever done in my life, I put it all into Creative Commons, which is essentially public domain, really. You know, stop this nonsense about whatever creativity I make, I need to copyright it and forbid anybody else to use it. I want to make some money off of it, you know. Oh my gosh, multidimensionality, the thing is, multidimensionality is that the output of creativity, the flow that's going through you, that is so enormous and so beautiful and spontaneous and seamless. And it's, you know, you just have to let it go. You can't be saying, whoa, wait a minute, I want to copyright this. Where do I cut the song off? You know, this is an incredible song, the best song I've ever heard. And how do I copyright it? Let me see if I can wake up and write it down. Listen, I get, you know, get this, let me publish it. Let me put a music video up, let me copyright it. Let me try to be famous. If people could just hear this, you know, they would say I'm the best musician of all time, et cetera, et cetera. All this stuff that kills multidimensionality. You know, in a previous lifetime, I was involved with music, and I copyrighted a lot of music, and I paid the price of that this lifetime, horrible price, because I played a role in the whole copyright situation for musicians, and of course it's a way to make a living at that time, but it gets in the way of multidimensionality, because you will experience glorious music. Glorious expressions of creativity that are shifting and morphing and just out of this world so beautiful, and you just have to let it keep on going. You can't try and say, wait a minute, I want to grab hold of this and put and market it. No. So because that'll stop it. That'll stop the whole multidimensional experience, because you'll feel overwhelmed. You'll say, wait a minute, all this profit opportunity is slipping right through my fingers. This is horrible. That's why Jesus said it's harder for a rich man to enter the kingdom of heaven than it is for a camel to go through the eye of a needle. And I don't know if anyone's really understood that properly. I'll tell you exactly what it is. A rich man gets rich because they exploit opportunities. They market commodities. Music, a song, is a commodity. All right, it's got a start and a beginning, and it's set in stone, and it's you know, published. Songwriter, the musicians, the publisher, and people try to make money off of it. And rich people get rich by being very successful in marketing commodities and packaging commodities. Now, when a rich person experiences multidimensionality, they're going to see endless opportunities for commodities, for beauty, to stuff to sell, to package, to market. And they'll see so much that it'll blow their mind. They'll say, whoa, I could be the richest person in the world if I could just somehow market all this. And so instead of just continuing to experience this, they pull away from it, and they start focusing on how in the world can I market all this stuff, and how can I get it into some kind of packaging here in this world, some sort of, you know, expression here in this world, a linear expression, so I can market as a commodity. And so they become obsessed with that, and they really become terrified to experience multidimensionality, because it, to them, it seems like they're losing opportunity. They're saying, oh, this is slipping through my fingers, my God. I mean, imagine like a person who was a miser, a hoarder, and someone was pouring gold coins into their hands. And they would, you know, try to fill up their hands as much as possible, and they'd try to, you know, expand their hands and pull into their chest and try to hold on all these gold coins. And what if the gold coins just kept on pouring? and pouring and pouring and pouring, and never stop pouring. There's a pile of gold around the miser, and the miser's trying to, you know, starts getting so upset. They say, "Oh my gosh, I got my hands full of gold, but look at all the coins that are slipping through my hands, that are falling off my hands, because my hands are too full. They're so full, and I'm missing all these opportunities." And instead of, you know, being happy, like, "Wow, look at all this gold," they get, you know, despondent because they're missing all these opportunities. They're slipping, passing them by. That is the problem with multidimensionality and the quote-unquote the rich person, the rich man, who wants to exploit every opportunity that possible. Which is why I'm saying it's so important to put your work into Creative Commons. Anybody posting, any music right now, I'm telling you, the best advice I can give you right now is whatever you are creating, put it in the Creative Commons and public domain. Just do it. I've done it. I spent so much effort and time composing music. I put it all into Creative Commons. Let it go. Let it go. Let it all go. I put all my videos on YouTube into Creative Commons. Let it all go. It'll come back to you infinitefold. Because why? Because you won't be trying to accumulate anything. You won't be trying to claim anything for your own profit, to grasp a hold of something. You won't be trying to grab a thread of multidimensionality and say, "I'm going to grab this thread and I'm going to manufacture this and I'm going to make $1 billion off of this." No, because then everything else that is flowing there available to you, you'll be blind to it. You won't pay attention to it and you'll lose the experience of multidimensionality. Because the riches of multidimensionality are infinite. They're so great. You don't even, the idea of like trying to grab a hold of one and sell it is ridiculous. Because you know you'll miss out on everything else. So the practical step you can take right now, do some creative work and make it, put it into public domain, Creative Commons, let go of it, share it with the world without any restrictions. Copyright free. All my work is copyright free. I don't make any claim to own, hold any copyright or intellectual property to anything. And that's an unbelievable turnaround for me, who was literally trying to make the very best creative stuff in the world and try to make a living off of that, and it completely failed. Where in a previous life, I was very rich because I succeeded in marketing creativity to a very high extent and made a ton of money. Now, I gave the money away to people, that is true, but I didn't give the creative efforts away. I didn't give them freely to the world. But right now, because multidimensionality is here now, and the next 6 months are so crucial, take that step, see how you feel. Maybe you're going to struggle with it a little bit, sure. I kind of hesitated, it was hard for me, very difficult. I held on to stuff for so long thinking someday I'm going to market this. I mean, at one time I had produced over 50 VHS videos full of original music that I had composed, beautiful music, immense effort on video with After Effects, Adobe After Effects and Photoshop, and live mixing and video feedback. I just didn't amaze. Some of the stuff was absolutely amazing. Astonishing how beautiful it was, abstract in many ways, and all different types of videos. I had 55 on VHS tape. I spent my whole life working on it, and I couldn't sell any of it. I couldn't market any of it. And I became so despondent over not being able to earn even a penny from all my years and years and years of labor and investment, massive investment in digital, all sorts of equipment. Musical equipment and time and effort and everything, I couldn't make even a penny off of it. And finally, I got so upset, I took all of my VHS videos, all my creative work, Photoshop, just thousands and thousands and thousands of incredible pictures and artwork and special effects and everything, and I threw it all in a dumpster. I found a dumpster on the street. I threw everything in a dumpster. I got rid of everything I ever did and just threw it all away. I was that upset. And looking back on it, you know, that was a fit of a temper tantrum, you know. At that time, Creative Commons was not used at all. And the idea of public domain, it just, you know, I had spent so much money I mean, I did all the duplication myself. I did everything. I'd spent so much. I wanted a return on my investment, of course. I was trying to find some way to live. But it didn't work out. It was a catastrophe for me. So with that experience in mind, when I started doing all these videos here, I put up a whole bunch of videos actually in years gone by, and nobody really watched them because they weren't Creative Commons. Actually, YouTube did not have a Creative Commons option at that time, so they were just standard YouTube license. Nobody watched them, so I took them all down. I think there was like a couple hundred of them, videos that I have posted previously. With very detailed explanations and clarifications of the whole situation in the world. I took all of them down. I still have I have them, but in downloading them, there's some problem occurred in the download of all these videos when I downloaded them off of YouTube. And they all got distorted. All got distorted. I have the originals, actually, video. The very large size. So I kind of like lost those two in a certain way. The audio's distorted. It's all messed up. So when YouTube finally put Creative Commons in, and when I saw that, I said, you know what? Let's just do that. Let's just give freely to the world. I've been through so much hell trying to market creativity. So forget it. Just forget it. Okay? Let's just say, everybody, here it is. You like it? You know, great. You want to do something with it? Great. Whatever you want. It's not my problem anymore. What you do with it. I don't care what you do with it. I really don't. And some people have used some of my clips in nice ways. That's fine. Whatever they want to do. I'm not keeping track. I just stumbled across a couple. I said, that's good. That's fine. But I'm not looking for anybody how they're using anything. It's not my look at it. I don't care. So creativity freed it. I freed up, and I think that has helped me be able to move into multidimensionality. Because there, the creativity is again infinite, and effortless, and endless. So why spend any time trying to copyright anything, trying to bind anything? You know, trying to say, hey, look what I did, because everybody can do the same. The real service to the world is to tell people about multidimensionality. And to help move into that. And so they can experience it for themselves. And when they do, they won't be interested in creating anything in this world anymore. You know, like composing some music and trying to sell it. Even giving it away, they won't even be interested in that anymore. Because it's like dust compared to experiencing multidimensionality. What people will be doing is exhorting everyone else and, hey, you know, just shift into multidimensionality. That's where it's really at. Don't hoard your creativity. You're just robbing from yourself. Robbing from yourself. And it's amazing on YouTube how few people put it into Creative Commons. You know, there are a few channels of people do it. Even then, they do for a little while, and then they switch back to regular licensing. I guess they get spooked. They think, oh my gosh, I took this video. I don't want anybody else using it. It's copyright, you know. Come on. We all have video cameras now. We have, you know, iPhone, smartphones. We have video cameras. I carry a video camera around, HD video camera. And, you know, we can all take video all the time we want to take. Why not just say, hey, everybody, this is free. This is shared. I don't own this is not my intellectual property, you know. I just, you know, I'm just sharing this because I want everyone to move toward multidimensionality. And this is a powerful way to do it in this world. Probably the best thing that ever happened is this Creative Commons movement. Because this is waking up to multidimensionality where everything is shared. There's been a lot of that going on with the music, digital music, and all the fights over copyright, etc. But this is a little different. This is like doing your own efforts, okay, and then sharing that with the world. Whereas just pirating other people's efforts and just so you can watch it, etc. That's not the same thing. What we're talking about here is the video you take, your efforts, the music you compose, whatever you're doing. Sharing it and saying, it doesn't belong to me, it doesn't belong to anyone. It's just here. It's just a blessing just to be able to share this. That is going to really, really boost you into multidimensionality if you can get used to that and you feel comfortable with it, which has taken me a long time. Because what, like this background you're seeing here, I mean, do you think that was easy to come up with this? I spent 5 years of my life collecting the pictures of Ananda Maima. I'll get you see on the right there, for instance. I spent an enormous time, money, time, and effort trying to get every picture of her that exists. And then photoshopping it and cleaning it up and working with these pictures. An incredible effort I put into it. And then I was able to get software where I was able to get this like a slideshow film strip of her and put that together. And then Jesus, I downloaded those from someone who did put them in Creative Commons, left here. And then on the top are actually pictures of the Palm Springs area that I would go down there and take photographs and drive all over and go to all these beautiful places and took all these photos. And then I would, you know, I had to work on them in a photo editing program. I did a special effects on them. I spent a lot of effort on that. And the bottom one is Nicholas Roerich, who was one of the world's greatest painters without question. And I'm using these with fair usage. These are from the Nicholas Roerich Museum. And, you know, I downloaded all those and worked with those, put those in a slide program. And then I was able to put these film strips onto a background using some kind of, you know, a lot of effort and technology to do this. So it just represents like an incredible, enormous investment in effort, time, creativity, etc., etc., etc. But you know what? Just putting it all out there, saying, you know, here it is, enjoy it for everyone. It's not mine, doesn't belong to me, doesn't belong to anyone. It belongs to everyone. Multidimensionality belongs to everyone. All creativity that arises belongs to everyone. It's all free for everybody. There's no cost to it whatsoever. There's no cost to it. There's no copyright in multidimensionality. Who's going to buy anything? Because everyone can experience everything themselves. And they're capable of doing it. As soon as someone tries to bind creativity to matter, to form, and shut down multidimensionality, they end up impoverishing themselves. What a terrible trade-off. In the attempt to become rich, like with money, we shut down our experiencing of multidimensionality. Incredible, huh? That's the worst trade-off ever. It's the most foolish trade-off ever. Pity the rich people. Pity them. Really pity them. When you experience multidimensionality, you will truly pity the rich people, the people who are desperately trying to become rich. It's like they're desperately trying to gather together a little pile of dust and crowing about it and thinking, this is it, this is it. Where the completely eternal and endless vast panorama of multidimensionality is right there for them to turn to and experience. And in one instant, they'll experience greater riches than anything they could ever have imagined with their little pile of dust. And yet they're busy, you know, passing laws and rules and hiring lawyers and fighting and clawing and scratching and pummeling and cheating and lying and distorting and intimidating and doing everything possible to get that little speck of dust, like two more specks of dust than someone else. And you know, it's just, it's so sad, so sad. So pity the rich. And do not cultivate that type of mindset. I haven't been able to accumulate any money in my life, this life. In the previous one, I accumulated a ton of money. And even though I used it, you know, with charity and philanthropy and helping everybody out, still the accumulation, the desire to accumulate was there. And that's what sinks multidimensionality. It prevents. Because, you know, I was thinking like, hey, even if you want to help somebody, be careful. Like I might see something in multidimensional, I said, oh my gosh, if I could just put that in a bottle, I could sell it And a billion people would love it. You know, it's so beautiful. Like, what a, I could make a beautiful song that would, people would love to listen to it, and it would bring some consolation to their misery, and it would be a great thing for the world. So if I could just, you know, bottle that a little and freeze it, that just little part of it. Yeah, but you know what? In doing that, I lose sight of multidimensionality. And no matter how nice that little song might be, it misleads people into thinking this is it. You don't see the gurus doing that, do you? Ananda my Ma didn't do that at all. She wasn't creative at all. Just did not try to do anything like that. Jesus, what did he create? Did he sit down? Did he weave things? Did he paint pictures? I mean, what was he creative? No. Because they're telling us, hey, kingdom of heaven is within. Multidimensionality is not a situation where you're trying to precipitate snippets of it into a material form, to set form. Not at all. That's how you impoverish yourself. So free yourself from that. If you're a painter, make a painting, and you can put it online, the picture of it or something, and say, this is free for everybody. Free for everyone. Don't even have to attribute to me or anything. Just enjoy it. And hey, not only enjoy it, keep in mind that multidimensionality is better than this picture. As I'm telling you now, with this very sophisticated simulation of multidimensionality, I'm saying this is nothing compared to multidimensionality. Literally nothing. It's like zero. Zero. Okay, you're watching, what you're watching now is zero. Even though it has these great gurus and teachers and saviors and landscapes. I mean, there's no better painter than Nicholas Roark when it comes to landscapes. There's no more beautiful place in the world, I think, than the Palm Springs area. And there's no greater example of a guru than Anandamayi Ma. And there's no greater teacher of truth and exemplar of truth than Jesus Christ. And so here you have, you know, just the best of the best, the creme de la creme de la creme. And I'm still telling you, compared to experiencing multidimensionality, this, what you're seeing here, is a zero. That's flat, isn't it? It's a zero. Whatever depth you feel here is just imagining, and you're trying to use your imagination instead of actually experiencing multidimensionality. It's a zero. And as one who has put in an unbelievable amount of work, creative work in this world, I'd really tried to find the highest form of creativity, you know, and something like this background here blends, you know, just threads, like I'm weaving threads here. You can see it's like weaving a thread. It's like trying to simulate multidimensionality, where you just have all of these gorgeous, gorgeous, wonderful visuals. Holy, divine, beautiful, all these different things, weaving them together, you know, like this. And then here I am saying it's a zero. It's a zero. And that's okay. Because when you experience multidimensionality, you don't care. It's easy to say whatever you've done before is a zero. Even if you've slaved your whole life on it, it's still a zero, and it doesn't bother you. Because you have the riches. You know where riches can be found. So why, you're not worried about saying, well, over there, there's nothing over there, but here I've got everything. That's not a problem. It's like if you have a glass of water, you're not worried about saying, well, all these pitchers of water, I don't need them. They're nothing. It's not a problem to say that. It's not scary to say that. So I'm saying this is nothing. It's all zero. That's how I feel. That's how I'm looking at it right now. Not in a negative, zero in a negative sense, but just factually in relate in comparison to multidimensionality, it's a zero. And we can go beyond zero. In fact, we will go beyond zero. It's easy to go beyond zero. And the next 6 months should be an amazing, incredible time opening up to multidimensionality. So here we go. It's going to be beyond our imagination, beyond our imagination. And again, what was my advice? Do something creative and put it in Creative Commons. Start doing it. If you've uploaded videos already on YouTube, what you need to do is you need to go back and on the licensing, on the, you know, edit info on your videos, it says licensing, standard YouTube license or Creative Commons, put it in Creative Commons. Set it free. Set yourself free from all your material forms of your, the material forms of your creativity. Set yourself free from that. And you will feel tremendous relief. I'm telling you, holding on to copyrights for your creativity is hell. It's hell. It really is. Because you're fighting other people. Look at the artists in this world out there. You know, terrible, desperate fight to squeeze money out of their creativity, their songs. They trying to track people down, have lawyers suing other people. And it's a nightmare. It's really a nightmare. Worrying about who's using, might be stealing your creative efforts. Some people in this world, well, I will say this, even those who purport to be spiritual people in this world, their websites, their videos, everything on it is all copyrighted, which blows my mind. It really blows my mind. And to me right there, that says it all. Okay, it says it all. One thing I love about Ananda Mayama is the people associated with her and how things have come down through time. There's very little copyright restriction. Very little. There's tremendous tolerance for using her image, her words, etc., in whatever way we want to use them. There's only a few examples of people trying to copyright anything concerning Ananda Mayama. She herself made absolutely no claims for any copyright whatsoever. Nothing. She no claims for ownership of anything in this world. None. Zero. And that example really, you know, permeates. And so I said, I cannot copyright anything has to do with her. Let it go. So a lot of spiritual websites, spiritual teachers, everything is copyright protected. And they're very, very strict about that and heavy-handed about it. It's like, this is our property. You know, you don't dare market this. You don't do anything with it. It's incredible. I get a feeling. I can tell very easy where someone's at spiritually. Very easy. Simply look at that one issue. And sometimes I read like the licensing, some of the information about copyright on their websites, and it's like, my God, it's like some lawyer from hell wrote those restrictions, saying we will come after you if you cannot use this for any purposes whatsoever, and we will come after you if you dare do that. It just terrifies you, you know. Say, oh my gosh, what if I feel inspired to use this, you know, in some kind of expression of my own love and devotion and go. No. That should be an absolute red flag for you. Okay? Absolute red flag. So just check it out. Any teacher you are listening to, check it out and see if their videos are in Creative Commons. Check out if they have made it absolutely clear to you that you're perfectly free to use anything that they're putting out there in any way you want to. They literally have no claim to it whatsoever. Check it out. Check it out. And you can easily tell who is supporting your multidimensionality. Your multidimensionality. Okay? A lot of these teachers get a glimpse of it and they think, oh my gosh, I can be Superman here. If I just figure out how to market this experience I had, I can be the greatest person in the world. You see? And they take it that way. And then they cut themselves off from their own experiencing of it, trying to be some religious leader, some cult leader, some great, you know, have a great organization and become fabulously wealthy and build hospitals and temples and everyone worship them, etc. They cut themselves off simply because they get a glimpse of it. They think, oh my gosh, if I could market this. I'm taping on. Okay. If I market this, it'll be fabulously wealthy. So you just look at that, and that will give you the clearest indication of where they're coming from and where they want to lead you to. And I guarantee you where you want to go to is to multidimensionality. You do not want to remain in the flatness of material expression here and spend your time worshiping anyone. I don't care who it is, even Ananda Mayamar, Jesus, or whoever, Ramana Maharshi. You do not want to spend your time in the flatness of fake multidimensionality, worshiping those teachers and listening to their teaching or anything. And that I guarantee you, they don't want you to do that either. They want to free you from that and let you, and they want you to experience multidimensionality. Okay? So if you come across teachers who are copywriting everything and selling everything and holding on to it, no. Think twice. Where are they taking me? They want you to stay where you're at and to focus on them as being something greater than you. And they want to milk you for your time and they want to keep you impoverished. Don't do it. Okay? Think about it. Consider it. Very, very consider that, because I tell you, you will remain impoverished. I don't care. I spent so many years surrounded by the best photographs of the most holy people in the world and the old sacred stuff from Christianity, so many beautiful paintings and holy things, and I had like a museum. I was surrounded, my whole world, I was surrounded by holy things. And you know what? My life was miserable. It was flat. And I said, I don't know what to do. You know, this isn't working for me. You can sit there, and I had the best music, the best of everything, but it was all flat. And I said, wow, this doesn't satisfy. It's unbelievable. So that's not it. It's not it. Free yourself from that. Take steps to free yourself from that. Convert all your licensing of everything you've done into Creative Commons and let it go. Let it go. And you know what? It'll come back to you as multidimensionality. And it'll be the best investment you ever, ever, ever made beyond anything you can possibly imagine. It's like you gave away nothing and you received everything. That's what you'll feel. You gave away nothing and received everything. Endless everything. And so who's the good business person right there? Think about it. We look at all these business titans in the world. Silicon Valley here, we've got a lot of the big shots here. And they're all over the world now. And think about who's the real big shot, though. Isn't it the one who gave away everything and received, gave away nothing and received everything in return? This world is nothing. Give it away. You'll receive everything in return, which is what multidimensionality is. It's everything. You literally will have everything. You'll have all experience at your fingertips, so to speak. And it will be seamless. It'll be incredible. It will all just flow. Just a flow. And the flow is unimpeachable, you know. It's impeccable. It's absolutely impeccable flow. Give up nothing and receive everything in return. And then, again, who's the astute business person? These moguls in this world who are you know, multi-billionaires, are they really the astute business people? Or is the one who has given away nothing and received everything the astute business person? I would say the latter, right? Who is successful in this world? Who is really successful? The one who gives away everything and receives everything. Who gives away nothing, really, because this world is nothing. But who gives it all up. Doesn't hold on to any attachments. Lets it all go. And receives everything in return. And we're right at that point where we can do that. It's always been possible to do that, but we're right at a point now where there's a huge upsurge in feeling that this is it. This is what we need to do. But a lot of people who have helped out in carrying this attitude into this world, and thanks to all of them who have kind of said, hey, why don't you put it in Creative Commons? And I remember a movie, I think it's called Sita Sings the Blues by Nina Palin or Nina Paley or something. Sita Sings the Blues. She did this incredible movie, one of the best I've ever seen. It's just gorgeous, just beautiful animation. She put it all in Creative Commons, public domain. She says, here, I'm giving it to the world. It's free. And that's what triggered me. When I saw that, I said, holy cow, if she can do that, I can do it too. And so I thanks to her. I don't quite remember her last name, but I think it's Sita Sings the Blues. You can look that up on YouTube and watch it. It's fantastic. The effort she put into that. And yet she said, you know what? It's very, very important for people to give their creativity away. And that, when I saw just the immense effort she put in, how beautiful it was, and she said, gave it away, says, it's yours. It's yours. As much as mine. It's yours as much as mine. I felt in my heart, you know what? That's the right thing to do. That is the right thing to do. And so then I started doing that. So it makes a difference. If you do that, people start picking up on that. There have been some musicians that have done that. Walter Mazzacaro, with his music, was in Creative Commons. I don't know if it still is or not, but I said, wow, it's really great that he did that. You know, it's really great. So anyone who does it, who just gives it away right now, you are really serving humanity in the best sense possible. You know, some creative genius was here and they just did this incredible music and then just gave it away for free to everybody. That would help the world more than anything. I tell you, it really would. It would piss off a lot of producers and moguls and stuff who make a living out of exploiting, you know, artists, making a ton of money off of them. They wouldn't be happy one bit because they'd say, oh my gosh, I could have made $1 billion off this artist. And here's this artist giving everything away for free. But that would really help the world. Really, really help the world. And it's, for me, I'm sad that I'm not able to. I'm too old and tired to really do that, unless I have some kind of renaissance. But it would be really great if talented people right now just give everything they're doing, just give it away and say, you know what? It's everyone's. This belongs to everyone, because multidimensionality belongs to everyone, and it's all free. And that would trigger remembrance in us. So this video here is free. That belongs to everyone. All right. And really seriously consider going back and on your videos that you posted and changing the license to Creative Commons and say, make your statement, make your help out the situation saying, ah, you know what? This should help remind you of multidimensionality, where everything is free, freely given, freely received. We're at this wonderful opportunity, and if you've got great talent, put it out there for free. You're going to help everybody. You're going to help yourself enormously. Enormously, because great artists are prisoners of their talent, because everybody wants to make a buck off of them. Everybody, okay? I experienced that in this world. It scared me. I tried to hide my talents because I had been through it before, and I know everybody wants to exploit you. They want to make a buck off of you. They'll tear you to pieces. They'll kill the goose that laid the golden egg. They'll run you into suicide just to make as much money as possible selling your creative endeavors, packaging and selling them to the public. So you become a prisoner of that. You have all these people you're supporting, all these people making money off of you, and they want to control your life, and they want you to do what they want you to do. They say, well, look, this is what sells. We want you to do that. We want you to only do that. We don't want you to do anything else. We want to control your life. And your life becomes hell. So turn the tables and say, everything I do is free. Public domain belongs to everyone. And you will free yourself from hell. Literally, you'll free yourself from hell. I'm just going to, you know, if I had access to all the most beautiful stuff in the world, I'd just post it on YouTube for free, you know, Creative Commons, public domain. Here it is. Belongs to everybody. I've been trying to put up a lot of beautiful stuff, but a lot of what I've used, everything I've used almost, is from others who have put up in Creative Commons. Thanks to all of those people. They've made it possible. They've created a groundswell. It's very, very, very helpful. I try to list them when at all times, those who have contributed and Creative Commons have made it possible for me to amplify this. Very, very important. All right. We're just about in an hour here, and it's been a very, very great hour to get this all out. Get this all out and to touch upon stuff that is really profound. Really profound. And you can tell from my voice that experiencing multidimensionality is a very, very profound experience. It just casts light and shed light on the entire situation here. And you can have that experience too. Just set everything free. Set yourself free. Don't hold on to anything. Say, this is mine, 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 mine. No. Just let go of all that and you'll have everything. All right. Very great. That's it for this video.